Run, Forrest, run!
Appreciate the help. Wish I had more work for you.
You mentioned a reward before?
No, I mentioned you might accidentally get supplies.
I missed to leveling up again.
Not allowed to contract mercenaries at the outpost. Still, a requisition form or two can get lost, and they're not gonna come check. So here you go. Just between us.
Thank you. I need that, because I'm starting to run out of ammo. He says starting. No, I'm 100% out of ammo. Start using this. This should be fine. Start gunning people down with the ferocity of a semi-automatic weapon. My guy really can't run that far, can he? Damn. Oh, bark scorpions. Not what I was after, but... good to know. We can use that to see if I... mod? What do I have to mod it? Oh, nothing. Well, that's a war crime. No, seriously, that's actually a war crime. I still don't see smoke that she mentioned. Oh well. I hear gunfire for some reason. Oh, because of him, okay. I wonder if that's Oliver. No, Oliver doesn't have a gun on him, doesn't he? Who are you?
Did you see that? That crazy bitch just attacked me out of nowhere.
Did you know her?
Not for long. I met her on the road a few days ago, and we've been traveling together since. We'd actually been flirting a little when she suddenly pulled a gun out and began yelling at me to hand my caps over. Now that I think of it, though, she laughed when I threw her my money. I think what she really wanted was my Lucky Charm necklace.
Lucky Charm necklace?
Yeah, every once in a while you can find a cap with a blue star on it. They're pretty rare, so I started collecting them. Once I had enough, I made a necklace out of them, since I thought they were lucky.
All sorts of nasty people are looking for caps like those. You'd be safer if you got rid of them.
Really? I had no idea. And here I've been carrying them all this time, never knowing how dangerous they were. What do you think I should do with them? Bury them or something?
I can hold on to them for you. I'm not worried about the people that are looking for them.
They're all yours. I sincerely hope they work better for you than they did for me.
I just convinced this bitch to give me his shit for free. poor bastard. Now I see the smoke. And a shirtless guy.
Yeah! Whoop-a-golly! I did! Smell that air! Couldn't you just drink it like booze?
Are you feeling alright?
Are you kidding me? Never felt better! Yeah!
What sort of lottery did you win?
What lottery? The lottery! That's what lottery! Are you stupid? Only lottery that matters! Oh, oh my god, smell that air!
See you later.
Bye.
Bye, bitch. Compass marker added? Oh, I think it's just talking about the fact that I've found Nipton. I'll put these poor bastards out of their misery. Also, they should theoretically just, you know, sit there. They shouldn't just lose their... Okay, the bird doesn't exist. Neither does his skull anymore, apparently.
Don't worry. I won't have you lashed to a cross like the rest of these degenerates. It's useful that you happen by. I want you to witness the fate of the town of Nipton, to memorize every detail. And then, when you move on, I want you to teach everyone you meet the lesson that Kaisar's Legion taught here. Especially any NCR troops you run across.
What lessons did you teach
here? Where to begin? That they are weak, and we are strong? This much was known already. But the depths of their moral sickness, their disillusion? Nipton serves as the perfect object lesson.
What exactly happened here?
Nipton was a wicked place. Debased and corrupt. It served all comers, so long as they paid. Profligate troops, powder gangers, men of the Legion, such as myself. The people here didn't care. It was a town of whores. For a pittance, the town agreed to lead those it had sheltered into a trap. Only when I sprang it did they realize they were caught inside it too.
You captured everyone?
Yes, and herded them to the center of town. I told them their sins, the foremost being disloyalty. I told them that when legionaries are disloyal, some are punished, the others made to watch. And I announced the lottery. Each clutched his ticket, hoping it would set him free. Each did nothing, even when loved ones were dragged away to be killed.
Yeah, because everyone only cares about themselves, and that is a war crime.
Innocent. Hardly. Cowardly, though. They outnumbered us, yet not once did they try to resist. They stood and watched as their fellows were butchered, crucified, and burned. One by one, they stood and hoped their turn would not come. Each cared only for himself. As are all crimes, if you feel strongly about it, attack us, and soon you won't feel a thing.
Yeah, I'm not gonna do that. Oh, yeah. One of the many reasons I picked the Wild Wasteland perk is just over here. So as we can see, we see a destroyed house with two charred bodies in front of it. One named Owen, and another named Beru.
Owen! And Beru! Owen!
Uncle Owen? Aunt Beru? Better not tell Luke what happened here, eh? Also, we were in California, apparently. I'll go to Novak first, and then... do that mission. Also, my hand just keeps going through my face, apparently. Just shoot the landmine. Like that. That's what I wanted. I have no ammo in that. All that, I just have ammo in this. Of course I'm getting shot from both sides. Cool, he should have some 9mm ammo. Now we just gotta casually descend the hill. How did he die? Was there another landmine? Is the other guy being chased by a bighorn? No, he's running to us now, okay. Yeah! As if he'll survive. If I had better weapons, I'd try and take down the Legion too, because I hate the Legion. The only thing I like about the Legion is they decided to try and remake the Roman Empire. This guy's just got a 357 into his friend's back. Is that a 357, or are you just happy to see me? That's one of those. says he won't go into a place he knows where there's an ambush, immediately gets ambushed. Oh, wow. I wonder if there are Vipers at the Vipers Highway 95 encampment. I'll take that scrap electronics, thank you very much. And I'll take that scrap metal too. You'll never know when you need it. I've got an even more powerful machine gun. Now I can commit. Okay, now I can kill more Vipers. Easier. Novak. Do not belittle the super mutants for taking the bunny slope. We are now in the great town of Novak. I can ask people if they've seen a checker-suited man.
Well, welcome to you. You look tired from the road. Why don't you relax a spell? Let this fine town take care of you.
Fine town. We haven't met yet.
Oh, what am I doing? I got to thinking about making a good impression and plain forgot to tell you my name.
I wonder what her name is.
I'm Jeannie May. I take care of folks here at the motel, long as they aren't troublemakers.
I'm looking
Well, he might have been wearing a fancy outfit, but he wasn't any kind of gentleman to me. Had his nose stuck so high in the air you couldn't see it above the clouds. City folk, they always think they deserve better than what they got. Those hoodlums he was with seemed to know Manny for some reason. He's our daytime sniper, up in the dinosaur's mouth.
He's gonna ask us to do something, isn't he?
Well, I think that's a fine idea. I'll give you a good flat rate, and you can stay as long as you like. At least until the busy season comes. Sound good?
Yeah, sure. He's 100 caps.
I'm glad you can stay.
I probably only have like 300 to begin with, but
the one upstairs, closest to the lobby side. Here's your key. Let me know if there's anything I can do to make your stay better for you.
No problem, Jeannie May. Stay safe, stay happy. Peace.